Hey everyone, SDXL has been released and some interesting tips and tricks have already emerged to make the process of creating your digital art faster and more efficient. In this video, I will try to share a few of them that I've come across on Reddit and Twitter, trick with names. The old trick with names still works and works even better. For those who are not aware, the model can understand names and generate people with similar appearances, even with different seats. So if you need a stereotypical caricature or are tired of seeing the same age of faces, try experimenting with names and you might find exactly what you're looking for. Cinema style. SDXL can replicate movie styles with appropriate color grading. Here's some result which I got in a clip draw. Some users claim that it does it perfectly. I also find it very good, but it strongly depends a lot on particular actor and particular film. Users are suggesting to use the following prompt. Superman Jim Carrey in the Sin City style is my favorite one, because I even get red S on his chest and thus look just amazing. New supported resolutions. SDXL has a following list of recommended resolutions. This list is taken from the official website of Stability for SDXL 0.9, and of course this is applicable to SDXL. That's really cool, especially considering that the previous version of Stable Diffusion was trained on images with way more low resolution. If you use a different resolution, you could encounter strange distortions, object duplications, and other artifacts. Moreover, on the official website of Stability, they have described the recommended and allowable parameters of the sample, such as steps and CFG scale. Take a screenshot if you are not familiar with them. Style specifying. In one of the Reddit posts, there is a description on how to input preset styles that already exist in SDXL. Special scene walls are used for this purpose and it looks strange. It works for some people, but not for others. On the other hand, I use ConfUI and input the style in the most obvious and straightforward way, and it works perfectly. Perhaps SDXL better understands prompts, and it may not be necessary to go through the hassle. I decided to test it out and simply enter the prompt with a style in the clip drop service without specifying the style below. As I suspected, everything worked just the same. And by the way, practical experience shows that an extensive wall of negative prompts no longer needed. Ugly faces. If you generated a photo of small people, long shot, but ended up with poor faces, it's highly likely that this issue lies with the use of VAE. The solution to this problem is quite simple. Stop using it or try another VAE model, as the results are likely to be significantly better. Currently, there is only one available VAE model, and I will leave a link in the description. However, I'm sure that soon there will be many more VAE models to choose from. Child faces. Sometimes, during image generation, you may get people having childlike faces, which I have personally encountered as well. Instead of specifying an age, it's better to use a prompt like middle-aged or something similar, which works much better. Providing a specific age is not a good idea since the model has a better understanding of age categories rather than exact ages. ROM leakage. Many users of Automatic 1111 suffer from high ROM consumption. To fix this, you need to disable model caching in the settings. Additionally, if you have a lot of video memory but limited ROM, you can use VROM as a supplement when you run out of ROM by using the specific command lower ROM. Overall, this is one of the reasons I couldn't run Automatic 1111 in a Google Colab. 12 gigs of ROM and 16 gigs of VROM simply isn't enough for Automatic 1111. In general, Automatic 1111 performs significantly worse than ConfUI, as confirmed by Reddit users in their tests. VAE artifacts. As I mentioned in one of my videos, some users have noted the appearance of artifacts in some images, which was related to the official VAE. However, the problem can be easily solved by using VAE for model SDXL 0.9. That should completely resolve this issue. Artistic style. SDXL, like its predecessor, utilizes images from various artists, each possessing its unique style. Thanks to this, you can recreate a similar style simply by specifying the artist and tags. One Reddit user generated 500 rabbits in different styles, allowing you to quickly and easily understand which style suits your needs. I'll leave a link in the description. Additionally, I will attach a link to a document containing a comprehensive list of artists. image with text generation. As you know, SDXL can generate images with readable text. However, it's important to know that it's not perfect, and sometimes SDXL may produce bad results. When you wonder which prompt structure can provide the best results, and I found the following. However, I experimented with various prompts and can say that there is not much difference. The key is to include your desired text with quotes and specify the object on which the text should appear. It's preferable to keep description of your object relatively brief, not exceeding 20 words, which in my opinion is quite sufficient. LoRA models that you might not need. SDXL is trained on a significantly larger dataset, so before seeking a specialized model for individuals, actors like Gal Gadot or Margot Robbie, it's better to try something with base model first. There is a high chance that you will achieve good results. Reverse engineered images. Imagine a situation where you have an image and you want to recreate something similar using Stable Diffusion. To save time or writing prompts, you can simply send the image to Bing or Bart, and they will generate a prompt for you. I've experimented with this method and achieved quite good results. Generate images using clip drop service. Sometimes the generated images turn out to be almost identical to the original, but this is largely depends on the input image. At the same time, you have the flexibility to fine-tune the result to achieve the desired outcome. And finally, one last detail. Every time I launch Coffee UI, the same seat is specified in the interface settings. If you are not familiar with what seat is, it's number that, when no, allows you to easily reproduce the results. If you need to obtain different images with the same prompt, simply add a comma to the prompt, just use seat 0. Do you like this format? Let me know by pressing like button, and if you know some other tips, share with us in the comments. Bye bye.